Philippine shares capped a data-heavy week with another loss as investors take cautious from slower economic growth. Friday's market wrap from Michelle Ong.
Asian equities mirrored Wall Street's gains Friday after the Federal Reserve cut interest rates, as expected, while signaling confidence in the U.S. economy. For the day, however, the PSE index lost 0.5%, closing at 69.77, also notching its third weekly loss.
Considering the recent dip in the market, investors could consider adopting a more selective approach as the market is currently facing uncertainties due to geopolitical and economic factors such as trade policies and foreign relations and also global supply chains. So right now, our current stock picks involve the energy sector, especially those involved in renewable energy or those that have strong domestic energy supply contracts. Consumer staples, which are usually resilient and considered as safe haven stocks during these times of uncertainties and less sensitive to macroeconomic swings. Telcos as well, since the demand for communication services remains relatively stable, and real estate, since industrial real estate and commercial leasing could offer better returns.
In corporate stories, Globe Telecom net 6 billion pesos in the third quarter, bringing nine-month earnings to nearly 21 billion on the back of record service revenues from the mobile business and corporate data business, which helped offset declines in the home broadband business and fixed line. While non-telco revenues fell 56% to 4.1 billion, mainly due to the deconsolidation of EasyPay from Globe's books following the sale of its 77% stake to Mint. Excluding the one-time gain from the tower sale, normalized net income would have stood at 17.8 billion, or up by 20% from the year earlier, and a minimal 3% decrease on a quarterly basis. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.